यस बच्चों, हाउ आर यू? शो 12 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 2.2 लीनियर इक्वेशन इन वन वेरिएबल क्लास 8 एनसीईआरटी सिलेबस वो ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड एंड आई होप दैट देयर वाज नो प्रॉब्लम इन एनी क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम योर साइड बिकॉज आई डिडंट फाइंड एनी कमेंट्स सो आई होप देयर वाज नो प्रॉब्लम ओके सो फ्रॉम टू दिस विल बी 13 questions that we will going to discuss, and in this video we will complete this exercise 2.2. I think 4 questions are remain. Total numbers of questions are 16, and this is the 13th question. And question is: a rational number is such that when you multiply it by 5/2, it means you have a rational number, any number. X, let X is a number, when it multiply by 5/2, X will be multiplied by 5/2 and add 2/3. Then also we have to add 2/3 to the product. It means product of this rational number X and 5/2 and add 2/3 means to add to the product, you get minus 7/12. What is the number? ओके बच्चों, सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन. सो लेट रेशनल नंबर इज इक्वल टू एक्स. ओके, सो एज पर क्वेश्चन एपीक्यू वी कैन से दैट 5/2 इंटू एक्स प्रोडक्ट when we multiply and add 2/3 means this is a product and then in this product we have to add 2/3. Clear na? Okay, if you don't clear, if any issue, then read the question 2 times 3 times, try to understand what they want. In a rational number, there is a rational number, then we multiply with 5/2 and 2/3 will be added to this product, we will get minus 7/12. Okay, very simple. Now we have to find the x, means rational number. Okay, so first of all, what we will do, since 5/2 x will be here, no change, plus 2/3 will be transferred to right hand side. Okay, so minus 7/12 and plus will plus will become minus 2/3. Okay, now 12 and 3, what will be LCM bachcho? 12 and 3, 12 will be LCM. Check it from your side. Okay, so 12 will be LCM, so minus 7 and here 4 will be multiplied and divided because 12 is LCM, so 4 will be multiplied with 2, so minus 8 and upon 12, this is only LCM. Okay, minus 7 minus 18, it means minus 15 upon 12. We can cut this one. How? By 5 3 are 15, by 4 3 are 12, so minus 5/4. Okay, clear na? Okay, here 5/2 x is continue, will continue, there is no change. 5/2 into x, 5/2 into x. Now this 5/2 with x is multiplied, then we transfer at right hand side, then what will we do? What will happen? It will be going a division. So it will be reciprocal when we transfer right hand side, because it will go in a division. So minus 4/4 into 2/5. Is it okay? Fine. This 5 and this 5 will be relation, and 2 2 4. What is remain in the numerator? There is nothing, means 1 is there, and in denominator 2. So x is equal to minus 1 upon 2. So our answer is minus 1 upon 2. Okay, fine. So question number 13 is over. Now we will discuss question number 14. This question is also important. In such type of question, we already discussed in NCERT examples. So go to this my video of NCERT examples. Intro video of this 2.2.
Question is, Lakshmi is a cashier in a bank. Okay, so Lakshmi is a cashier in a bank. She has a currency notes denomination as rupees 100, 50 rupees and 10 rupees. So three types of notes Lakshmi have. Okay. Now, the ratio of the number of these notes is 2:3:5. This is the ratio. Means 100 respectively, it means what? 100 two times, 50 three times, then 10 rupees five times. Okay. Notes, numbers of notes. Again, they said the total cash with her is rupees 4 lakh. How many notes of each denomination does she have? Okay. तो ये हमें फाइन करनी है कि कितनी 100 रुपीस की नोट. ओके, सो नाउ 100 रुपीस, 50 रुपीस एंड 10 रुपीस. ओके, सो देयर इज अ नंबर्स ऑफ नोट. सो लेट 100 रुपीस नोट इज इक्वल टू 2x, 50 रुपीस नोट is equal to 3x and 10 rupees notes is equal to 5x. Okay, bachcha. Now what? Rupees means what? 4 lakh total. So 100 rupees. If numbers of notes of 2x is 100 rupees is 2x, right? So total value of 100 rupees what? So 100 into 2x. So this is the amount that we get from the 100 rupees note. Example, 2x, leave it 2x. If 10 rupees note of 100, then 1000 rupees of 100. If 20 notes of 100, it means 2000 rupees of from the 100 rupees note. Okay. So numbers of note will be multiplied with 100. We will get total amount from the 100 rupees note. Okay. Similarly, we will add 50 rupees note. Means what? 50 into 3x. So 50 rupees will be multiplied with numbers of note of 50, right? And then 10 rupees note. So 10 will be multiplied with 5x, because numbers of 10 rupees notes are 5x. So we'll multiply with 10. So from there we can find the total amount of the rupees in a form of a 10 rupees notes. Okay. But total amount is already given, 100, this and this, 50 and 10, which 4 lakh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is already given. Okay, so very simple, simplify this one, 100 into 2, 200x, plus 50 into 3, 150x, plus 10 into 5, 50x is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, bachcho. Sum of these will be what? 150 plus 50, 200, 200 plus 200, 400. So 400x is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 lakh. Okay. This 400 is multiplied with x. So it will be go in the right hand side. So in a division. So x is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 lakh upon 400. 0, 0, 0, 0 will be cut. 4. And here what? 1000 will remain, right? So x is equal to, cutting you know how to do, right? 4 lakh upon 400, so 1000 will remain. Okay, so you will check what you will check this calculation from your side in your notebook. Okay, now x is equal to 100, it means now what? 2 into 100, x is equal to 1000. So 100 rupees notes means 2 into 1000, it means 2000. Okay, 3 into 1000, it means 3000, right? And 5 into 1000, it means 5000. These are the types of the notes. Okay, so 2000 notes of 100, 3000 notes of 50 rupees and 5000 notes of 10 rupees. So total will be 4 lakh rupees. Okay, so
pause the video and note it down. Then we'll discuss question number 15 and question number 16. Okay? Question number 15. I have a total of rupees 300 coins. How many rupees coins? 300 rupees coins. Total rupees 300 rupees. Of denominations of rupees 1, rupees 2 and rupees 5. So there are three types of the coins, 1 rupees, 2 rupees and 5 rupees coins. Three types of the coins. Okay. Now, what they say, the number of rupees 2 coin is 3 times the number of rupees 5. So compare is given between 2 rupees coins and 5 rupees coins. 2 rupees coins are 3 times compared to 5 rupees coins. Okay, the total number of coins is rupees 160. So they are not giving 1 rupees, how many 1 rupees coins, only giving the comparison of 2 rupees coins and 5 rupees coins. Which one is the greater here? 3 times 2 rupees. Okay, so coins, 2 rupees coins are 3 times of 5 rupees coin. So 5 rupees coins are a smaller quantity. So what will be assumed? 5 rupees coin will be x. Okay, so before I told that smaller quantity will be taken as a variable. So take 5 coin is equal to x. So rupees 2 coins is equal to what? 3x, because they are given that 3 times of 5 rupees coins, right? Total coins given 160. So how much 1 rupees coin? Same question in example. Okay, recall that one. Okay, so rupees 1 coins is equal to total coins, how much? 160. Okay, we will subtract 5 rupees coins and 2 rupees coin from the total. So we will find 1 rupees coin, because there are 3 types of the coins. Okay, we know the total coins, we know the 5 rupees and 2 rupees coins. So we will subtract 5 rupees and 2 rupees coins from the total, 1 rupees coin will be remain, right? So total 160 coins, and we will subtract 5 rupees coins and 2 rupees coins. It will be what? X plus 3x. This is 5 rupees coins. This one are 2 rupees coins. So when we subtract this one, it seems like a x plus 3x, 160 minus 4x. So this much is a 1 rupees coin. Clear? Now, before we did same type of the questions, denomination of the 100, 15, 10 rupees, same questions. Now, we'll multiply the amount of this coin, means 5 rupees coins x. So 5 rupees into x. So this is the amount from the 5 rupees coin. Then we'll multiply 2 with 3x. This will be amount from the 2 rupees coins. 3x is the numbers of coins. And 1 rupees, it means 160 minus 4x. Okay, 1 into 160 minus 4x. So this much amount from the 1 rupees coins, but total amount is already given, which is 300. So this is nothing but 300. Okay, fine. Okay, so to calculation, 5 into x, 5x plus 2, 3 ja 6x plus 160 minus 4x is equal to what? 300. Okay, so 6 plus 5, 11x. 11 minus 4x, 7x. 7x. Now, this is 300 and this plus 160 will be go right hand side. It will be become minus 160. Minus 160. Okay. So, 7x is equal to 300 minus 160, 140. X is equal to
140, this 7 will go in a division. So when we cut this one, 20 20, so x is equal to 20. So we can find 5 rupees coins x, it means what? 20. So 5 rupees coins 20, 2 rupees coins 20 into 3, it means 3x, right? 3x. So 3 into 20 is equal to what? 60 coins. So 20 coins from 5 rupees, 60 coins from 2 rupees. So total will be what? 60 plus 20, or we can here also add, we can 1 rupees coins is equal to 160 minus 4x. X means what? X means 20, right? So 160 minus 4 into 20, 80. So 80. So 1 rupees coin, how much? 80. So this is our answer. Okay? Clear? Fine. So we did lots of questions, same concept. Okay, with same concept. So I think now you will do better. Last question of the exercise. The organizers of an essay competition decide that a winner in the competition gets a prize of rupees 100. Okay. So organizers decide that winner will be get 100 rupees. Okay. And participants who does not win gets a prize rupees 25. Matlab 25 rupees to all participants who has not win. Okay. So winners will get 100 rupees, participant get rupees 25, same like this. The total prize money distributed in rupees 3000. So total distribution will be 3000. Find the number of participants, is 63. Okay, so I think they want to find the winners and participants, something like this. So this may be question I have written something here mistake, but we need to find your winners as well as participant, and total participants are 63, something like this. Okay, so total participants 63. Okay, assume winners x, show loser or not winner. Okay, you can say not winner is equal to 63 minus x, right? 63 minus x, 3000 rupees he distributed. Okay, so numbers of winners are what? What x? Okay, so x participant get gift or prize 100 rupees, right? So total how many rupees will be go for winners? So numbers of winners into 100 rupees, right? If 10 winners are there, then 10 into 100, 1000 rupees distributed to the winners. If 15 winners, then 15 into 100, so 1500 rupees distributed to the winners. Right, so this is nothing but 100 into x goes to winners. Okay, plus 25 rupees distributors to losers, right? So 25 rupees distribute to the loser, 63 minus x. How they come 63 minus x? Numbers of participants minus winners will get 63 minus x. Clear na? Okay. But total amount distributed is what? 3000. Okay, bacho. Now, this is the equation that we have to solve. Okay, 100x plus 63 into 25. That I have to do multiplication here. This is my rough work area. Okay, so 63 into 25. 3 2 6, 6 2 12, 5 3 15, 6 5 30, and 31. 1575. My multiplication will be different from your method, okay? So don't go with this one. 1575 minus 25x is equal to what? 3000. Now 100x minus 25x, it means plus 75x plus minus subtraction. So plus will sign bigger number sign, so plus 75x plus 1575 will be transferred to right hand side, bachcho. So 3000, 1575 will be transferred to right hand side. It will be what? 1575 minus. See, so what you have did here? 100 plus 100x minus 25x, right? Two like terms, but here plus and minus, subtraction will be there. Plus sign, bigger number sign will, is plus. So plus sign is plus 75x. Then plus 1575 will be transferred to right hand side. Okay, so 3000 minus 1575. You understand? Okay, fine. Now 1425. Subtraction 3000 minus 1575 is equal to 1425. 75x. So now 75 is multiplied with the x. When we transfer to right hand side, what happened? 1425 upon 75. Okay, we'll try to cut it first with 5. With 5, so 5 2 ja 10, and 4 and 2 8 ja, and 5 ja. So here 15 5. Again we can find divide by it with 5. So 5 ja 25, and 35 means 7. Okay, again can divide by 3. So 19, right? So x is equal to what? 19. What is x here? Winners. Winners how much? 19. And 63 minus 19. Okay, so how much will be there? 13 means 4, and 5 1 means 4, right? 44. So 44 are participants. So this is our answer. You can write it separately. Or I am doing here some mixing, but in your notebook you have to do it clean work. Okay. So write it separately. So this exercise is over, bachcho. Exercise 2.2, very good exercise. Okay. Even I said that chapter 2 is also very nice. You have to do more practice, too much practice. My advice, all question with example, you need to write, you need to practice 2 to 3 times of your textbook. It's really fine for you, it's really good for you, you will get good numbers in your exam. Simple, do, practice and practice. Okay, bye. So over for this 2.2. Now next video for introduction of 2.3 and so on. Okay. Bye.